for the cheapest coins on the internet right now, head on over to Muttcoin Bank, guys. You can get 1,000,000 coins for 40 bucks with tax covered, instant delivery. You will get 24/7 customer support. And of course, if you guys do use code Poodle, you'll get 10% off and your EA tax covered. Hello everybody, Poodle back with another Madden Ultimate Team video, guys. Today, I'm gonna be going over the brand new golden tickets, guys. So we got, I believe it's four. It was Metcalf, Tebow, Snell, and Sweat are the golden tickets that we will be getting today in-game, guys. So super exciting. You know, it takes a little bit to get them on the block. When they first dropped, they were coming out in higher quantities, of course, but that was primarily because it was a bit more hype. You know, as we get into the later weeks, you know, we're already mid-May. We know the deal. Madden typically by mid-May is a bit slower than usual. So the things take a little long to get up on the block. Certain odds are always different. Sometimes the first day has even better odds because they try to spam packs, right? Although a lot of this is just circumstantial and maybe coincidences, but that's kind of what we can believe. Now, before we get into today's video, guys, if you are into the channel, hit that subscribe button, turn the notification bell, boys. Give this video a big thumbs up. And of course, if you haven't already, head on over down below. Hit the link for Muttcoin Bank and use code Poodle at checkout, guys. Super great deals using my code. Second, guys, I'm super excited. I'm gonna be honest with you guys, for Madden 22. I feel overall Madden 21 was a conversion year. This was a year that we moved over into next gen, where next gen wasn't too great. They focused more on it, but then at the end of the day, people cared for current gen more. I think next year's gonna be a big year in terms of, you know, in terms of next gen. I think that's gonna be our first real next gen game. So definitely think Madden 22 could be banger. But moving on, guys, get to the golden tickets. We have a few things to go over there. Head over to the auction house. Hopefully all of them are up. I believe a few are released up when I checked, because we always have to check. You know, it sucks to get into the video and then go in and don't see them, and then you gotta wait anyway. So I like to wait for everything to be up first. So let's sort by newest. Okay, so let's see. Tim Tebow is up. 99 overall Tim Tebow on the Broncos, which is super cool, because they could have went with his most recent team. They could have went with just about any team. They let him go on the Broncos for the card art, which I really do like, because I always hated when cards like did like when they gave AP the Washington football team jersey when he got his golden ticket. And that kind of just sucks, because you want to see AP in a Vikings jersey, right? That's kind of the deal. But moving on, Tim Tebow stats, quarterback improviser, which again, that doesn't matter as much because, of course, they have multiple buckets and archetypes for their abilities. Now this card looks super OP off the rip. 92 speed, 95 throw power, 98 short, 96 medium accuracy, 95 deep accuracy, 99 throw under pressure, 99 throw on the run, 95 play action. Now, of course, based off just the front of the card, he can get up to a 94 speed, which I wish would have been a little bit higher, but still good. He'll get 99 throw power, he'll get 99 throw short, 99 throw medium, and 95 throw deep. He's already has 99 throw under pressure, 99 throw on the run, he'll have 95 play action. 6'3", 286, that'd be huge. A good weight, 88 strength. Now, this is what's going to matter, guys, especially at next gen. He has 236 weight, which is good weight, 88 strength for a quarterback, 92 agility, 95 excel, 96 jumping. Let's see, he has 96 carrying, guys, which means he will be like almost like a running back. I know quarterbacks are kind of like just coded differently. Like, if you have ever realized that, carrying in certain games never really even mattered. Certain positions are just coded to protect the ball better than others. That's kind of always been a thing that we have to deal with. But hopefully this Tebow car with the certain carrying that he does have ends up being super beneficial, where you can just take it. 99 trucking, 92 change of direction, 91 stiff, 99 juke, 88 spin. Gonna be one of the best guys with the ball in his hand, like as far as quarterback goes. RG3 would be more about the long run and the elusiveness, but Tim Tebow is gonna be the quarterback power guy. The quarterback power is actually a pretty good run this year if you get the right one. Out of the Cardinals playbook, they had a great quarterback power play you still have. So pretty much, guys, if you utilize him right with quarterback power and goal line, you could be getting in a lot. If you could fall forward with that strength, break sack 99, break tackle 99. This Tim Tebow card's actually super, super good. Again, people will argue that his release isn't the best, but I really actually do like that Tim Tebow card. Next guy's DK Metcalf, strong safety. This card's gonna be crazy. 6'3", 228. Great body, like frame, good frame, good height. This is based off his Christmas present card. Okay, so his speed will be a 99. Well, let's go with the stats. 98 speed, 96 excel, 99 tackle, 95 play rec, 99 pursuit, 99 man, 99 zone, 99 hit power. Now, this is a golden ticket right here, guys. This is what you call a golden ticket. Everything is going to be just about 99 that you even get, you care about at least. And even then, guys, even some other stuff on there is going to be a 99 that's even beyond that, right? So who get the 99 zone man and hit power off the rip? He'll get 99 speed with sprinter, of course. So, guys, this card overall, it's just crazy. Gonna get 99 tackling. Yeah, this is a user card, right? Max speed, max tackle, max pursuit, max man, max zone, max hit power. Move on down. 88 strength, he'll have 94 catching, which is just crazy for a user card. 86 carrying. He'll get 90 change of direction, 94 spec catch, 93 catch in traffic. I don't think you guys understand how important those stats like spec and catching traffic are for like those crazy interceptions when like it's a one-on-one coverage or it's a jump ball. Like that's when they make those crazy plays. That's when he goes up and grabs the ball. 99 tackle, guys, of course. He gets 78 blocks, which could have been a little bit higher. But still, this card is absolutely unreal. That Metcalf card might be the best golden ticket they've released thus far. And if not, he's at least up there for it. There should be a few more. We have Benny Snell Jr. Running back for the Pittsburgh Steelers. Now, personally, I wouldn't have picked this card. I mean, it's just not exactly a flair card like some other ones would have been. But I understand that if you're a Steelers fan, you're looking for a guy. Maybe your theme team needed a running back, right? Now, if you're on the Steelers, maybe I would have made a Chase Claypool. That would have been a pretty crazy card. But I can see where you're coming from in terms of that. Minka, maybe. So, he gets 90. He'll get 98 speed, powered up and... No, sorry. Chemmed up with Sprinter. He already has 97 Excel. He'll have 96 Agility, 99 Carrying, 80 Catching, 95 Change of Direction, 99 Trucking, 99 Break Tackle. Now, personally, I've seen some recent 99 overall running backs that came out. Look a lot better than this card. I don't think this card looks all that great. They have the 99 Break Tackle Trucking, but they have better catching. They have better route running, typically. Speed's only going to be 98, which is going to hurt him. I don't know why they've given us like four or five players, maybe even six now, that just get only 98. Kind of annoying. 96 agility, of course, is decent. 99 awareness. He will get only 89 jumping, but again, no one jumps like that. Carrying 99. Stiff arm 99, that's good. Spin move 95. Juke 99, that's really good as well. Running backs like LT, who get like the route running all the way up there in the 80s and 90s, as well as the catching in the 80s and 90s. So I feel like overall there's better receiving backs, there's even better running backs and better power backs. There's better backs that are more elusive, more powerful, and more better catching all in one. So overall, Benny Snell doesn't just seem like that. He can do it all, but he doesn't seem like the best choice, right? So it's not that he's not a do it all back. He has power, he has, you know, he has the ability to catch, he has the ability to go ahead and outrun you. But there's a back that can outrun better. There's a back that can slightly juke and spin better. There's a guy that can also catch better and has similar power, but maybe even better strength. They're all in one package. So that's kind of why I'm discounting him a little bit here. Again, not a bad back. For Steelers team, he's going to go probably crazy, but just not my choice. Now we have Montez Sweat as the final one here. Right end speed rusher. Probably going to be the best right end in the game. 95 speed. 98 Excel. It's a crazy athlete right there. 88 strength. And if you ever like to play like sag off D, where like you just send them off the line, you put them in a zone real quick, you could probably sit there too. We mean 6'6", 88 strength, 98 tackle, 94 play rec, 97 block shed, 96 power move, and 99 finesse move. I probably put run stuff on him. With run stuff, guys, he'll have 99 finesse move, 99 block shed. He'll have a 97 speed, 97 speed, 98 excel at end. Guys, if he gets off the line of scrimmage, if he gets off the tackle, like it's over. If he gets off the tackle, that quarterback has no chance to run away. Most people don't even use escape artists this year, so they're done. They're done. And if they do use escape artists, Montez Sweat's keeping up, right? Because even though if it's a race, usually like an 80 speed plus end, like 80 to 90 speed plus, like right around their end, will actually start gaining ground on a quarterback if they don't have a proper release and proper energy. So a guy like Montez Sweat with a 97 speed, he may actually just outrun you the entire time. He might not even have to catch up, right? He'll just completely outrun you. 70 catching as well, which is what I was saying. If you put him like in a zone or man him up on a tight end real quick, like, you know, like when you know, you're on like a, you man up, they're on a five wide, you man him up, you shade inside, right? And that one tight end, you know that one tight end's gonna do a quick slant or something, but you gotta use or something over the middle. You could literally just man him up off the end spot or zone him right there, and he could pop out and have the speed too. And maybe even take it back. 80 to change of direction, 97 impact blocking, 75 zone. So again, if you put lockdown on him, guys, you could get him to an 80 zone coverage as well, which is pretty crazy. This guy could play like box safety, middle linebacker, and outside linebacker. Is a really good card. Yeah, that's about it, guys. So we had Tim Tebow today, DK Metcalf, Benny Snell Jr., and we had Montez Sweat. A really, really good golden ticket drop. I like all four of them. But if I had to rate them, worst, Benny Snell Jr. Third worst, Tim Tebow. Really good quarterback, but he's not the best quarterback. So of course, most people just choose the best quarterback. Second, Montez Sweat and DK Metcalf are tied first. I can't even debate that. They're both great cards. That's about it. Enjoy the rest of your day, guys. And subscribe, turn on the notification bell. If you guys need points, head over to my comment bank down below and use code POOLY. Thank you for watching. I'm out. Peace.